Now, this is called sui po. Sui po is something not really known, even amongst the practitioners of our school, because it is restrained, it is part of the Wuzhi Zen roots or roots. So, some masters say that sui po, they explain that sui po is really what greatly influenced the origins of Aikido Jujutsu. It should be noted, however, that this sui po was mostly a method that came from the arts within Wuzhi Zen. Everything was just one great set. There wasn't, since these things are quite ancient, there wasn't still this division by jutsu as we know. So jujutsu, aikijutsu were yet to be found and to be named. And of course, many people who study the history of old Japan say that there, when you call some art jujutsu, for example, there was this time in history that this skill, this jutsu was formally, say, accepted, this name was formally accepted by everyone. But they are pretty most, they all agree, it is pretty much universal that it didn't come just by, I don't know, by, from day to night. Even like Aikido Jutsu, you know, although there was this period in which Yoshimitsu Minamoto actually made the formal Aikido Jutsu set, the techniques already existed, or the root of those techniques. Many ideas were already there, present, spread all through the whole Japan. Therefore, this sui comes from water and ho comes from method. So the method of the water, but what really explains the anthropology of the name is not because it was something soft or loose. No, no, the idea is that many of these postures at the beginning of it were used to drown someone, to hold someone under water, especially when someone was wearing an armor. So this is already a middle position, you know? This is the middle of technique, so what I'm going to do here is I'll keep it stretched, you know, and keep his elbow that was supposed to be fractured by now. The idea is that I have already here arranged this foot over his leg. So what I'm actually going to do is I will step over his elbow and his foot like this. I could proceed to other very complicated positions. That is, his spine here is very loose, there is no support, there is no muscle to support this position. So this would be a very dangerous angle to be used. But you can see, this would be quite complicated and painful for him. Another technique is that in this position I will bring him down. Once I brought him down, I'm going to use this empty space in here and step over his humerus like this. So now that I'm here, I will use this angle. I can step over his humerus, or even step further, which makes it even more complicated for him. So what will prevent him to rotate his hip is that this pressure is brought downward and inward like this, which makes quite painful and difficult for him to move. So for this technique, you can see his leg is stretched over his other leg. So his knee is locked. You can see here, this is, I am on his limit, okay? I could kneel down here, which would certainly cause some injury on his leg, but there's no need for that. So now that I'm here, you see he is on his side, on the side of his hip. So his shoulder and scapula is compressed over there, his left shoulder. So I will bring him like this. Okay. And what I'm going to do is what the position asks us to do is to, you know, when I rotate like this, you can see his scapula is really compressed, and I could kneel down here too as well, so I have his elbow on the limit. I could also use just my bare hands for this, like here and here, which is a very painful position, you know? So if I kneel down, I will use just here, very slowly. Oh, okay, he's tapping already, okay? Because his knee is locked. Okay. Other thing we could do is even trying to smash this rhythm by kneeling down while actually on the ground. And this would make it very difficult for him to use his hips to escape and would prevent him to move or attack.